That sounded dirtier than I intended. Welcome to Ranger Reviews, a web series where we look at episodes of the TV show Power Rangers and then discuss them. Today we're exploring the 36th episode of the show Power Rangers Zeo, as well as the 191st episode overall titled Bomber in the Summer. We begin this episode at Ernie's new beach club thing that he started. There's Rastafari music playing and it's really awkward. Billy and Kat have moved some stuff for Ernie and Kat says that this is going to be the hottest summer hangout in town. Then a biker gang shows up because what the actual fuck is this show? They come down a hill going over to the beach and they just start driving through everything, knocking things off of tables and almost running people over. Billy and Kat go to the guy and they say that they're trespassing and Billy explains that this is a public beach, so buzz off. The biker dude says that they have 24 hours to clear off of their turf or else they're coming back and it won't be pretty. The girl on the back of the bike locks eyes with Jason as they leave. On Earth, Rito and Goldar are doing some work for Zed and Rita, firing a big blue rocket thing into the air. Of course, this ends with Rito getting clamped on by a crab, and Goldar hits it away, which causes Rito to toss away the remote he was using. At the Machine Empire, Machina and Sprocket talk about how it's going to be a while before Mondo is back, and suddenly, a rocket collides with them, revealing a brand new monster, Louie Kaboom. At the Youth Center, Jason is trying to convince Ernie that he can't close the beach club because it's not right, but Ernie isn't budging on this. He doesn't want anyone to get hurt because of him. Also, Rito and Goldar are looking for the remote, freaking out because without it, they'll have no way to control Louie Kaboom. They say they need some help and they see Bulk and Skull coming down the staircase down to the beach. Louie Kaboom then says he's the new ruler for some reason. And Machina is like, well, that sucks, which is really weird. No one's putting up a fight about this. The male ranger teens see that Ernie is bummed and Rocky says it's a shame the Power Rangers can't have a talk with those biker guys. Then the girl from the back of the bike walks in and Jason sees her. She orders a cola from the bar and Jason tells the others he'll be right back. He leaves and he asks her if they've met before. She says no, but he recognizes her gold elephant necklace and Jason calls her out on her BS. She tries to leave, but Jason tells her to calm down and maybe they can go somewhere else to talk about this. Meanwhile, Louie Kaboom is being polished by Clank and Orbis. Clank tells him that he needs to defeat the Power Rangers in order to earn Queen Machina's respect. Meanwhile, Bulk and Skull are sunbathing on the beach and of course, Bulk gets suntan lotion in his face. Also, Goldar and Rito come up telling them they need their help. Meanwhile, Jason and this girl, who is named Emily, are walking and she talks about how this guy, named Eddie, was one of the only people to give her the time of day when she first moved to Angel Grove. She doesn't know if she can tell Eddie to just leave it. Then they find the remote control for Louie Kaboom, but before they can do anything about it, Louie Kaboom is there, and he turns Emily's necklace into a brand new monster named Tuff Tusks. Emily runs away, and Jason just does a sick flip off of a cliff coming down. It's morphin' time! Jason takes on Tuff Tusks, and he's doing fine, but then the remote control gets zapped out of his hand, probably frying it, I guess. In the power chamber, Alpha and Billy see what's happening to Jason and they reach out to the others, but they keep saying, the Gold Ranger needs your help, which is really strange. It's like they weren't sure if this would be before or after they gave him an identity. Whatever, it's morphin' time for Tommy, which means it's morphin' time for everyone else, I guess. The five others show up, helping Jason up. They then get blasted at by Tuff Tusks all over again. Louie Kaboom is also soaked because he's sure this will make Machina love him. The Rangers then run away, hiding behind the coves, and the monsters are coming their way. Tommy tells Jason to use his staff while they use the Zeo laser pistols. They then come out, hitting Tuff Tusks and knocking him down. Louie Kaboom then comes to his monster's aid and they teleport out. Jason then tells him about the Louie Kaboom, and then he remembers the remote control, showing it to the others. Meanwhile, Bulk and Skull are searching for the remote control with a metal detector while Rito and Goldar are sunbathing. Then in the power chamber, Billy has found out that the remote control will control Louie Kaboom. Then the alarms go off, and they see that Louie Kaboom is with the giant Tuff Tusks. And just before they teleport, Zordon says that they have a sneak attack happening from the cogs right now. Apparently. And of course, Jason has to handle that part. The Fire Rangers show up to fight Louie Kaboom, the giant monster, while we see old footage of the Gold Ranger fighting Cogs that we saw in his premiere into the show. Lame. Also, Billy's having a lot of trouble with the wiring in this machine, trying to get it to work, but no. The other five then just get into their Super Zeo Zords and they check in with Jason, who says that there's just a few Cogs left. Apparently. Then Billy gets a remote control to work properly, and he uses it to teleport Louie Kaboom away. Just blow him up, Billy. The Rangers then leap into the air, forming the Super Zeo Megazord as they come back down. Jason then breezes through some cogs, taking them all out. Also, the Super Zeo Megazord is just using its dual sabers to cut random flags from Tuff Tusks with Japanese writing all over them. Hate crime. They then just do their finisher attack where they put the two sabers together, killing Tuff Tusks. Thanks for all your help in this fight, Jason. In space, Machina tells Louie Kaboom that he sucks, basically. Then back at the beach, Kat, Jason, and Tommy tell Ernie that they don't want him to shut down the beach club. Then the bikers show up again. They basically say that the beach is big enough for the both of them because of how Jason saved Emily earlier that day. Ernie, however, needs someone to help run the place because when they were going to be shutting it all down, the girl took another job that he had hired. Emily volunteers to help him. Then Emily and Jason talk as the music is playing, and it's pretty clear that they're interested in each other. Jason even gives her back her necklace. Where did he get that? Also, you would think that they're setting up Emily to be the damn Orange Ranger with how much orange she keeps wearing. In space, Rita and Zed demand that Rito and Goldar clean everything dressed as maids because they screwed things up with Louis Kaboom. The end. Okay, I'm totally biased, but I like all the Jason focus we've been getting lately. I mean, Austin St. John's return to the show has also shown another thing about him. He's actually a pretty good actor. He was by no means the best out of the original cast at all, but time away has actually done him pretty good. Then again, I think the material is also lending itself to a bit more deliverable things nowadays than, say, like, another episode with Pudgy Pig, but still. It's nice to see his progress. So Emily is a character that we have on this show now, I guess. Also, Ernie has an outdoor beach club. Like, why? Honestly, it's just nice to see them have the Rangers hang out at different locations every once in a while. But I will say that this episode was severely lacking in two things. Tanya and Adam. I mean, granted, Tommy, Rocky, and Kat barely said anything in the episode to begin with as well. But if we're going to focus on people, I mean, I'd gladly take Adam, Tanya, and Jason. So how will the next episode do? Will it be great or stink to the high heavens? That's a pun that you'll get next time. But until then, may the power protect you.